Good evening, people. Hello, hello.
Good evening, teacher.
Excellent. Thank you so much. Hi, Robert. Welcome to everyone. Oh, what happened with the rest? Hi, Fabi. Welcome, Jose. Hi, Kevin.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. Thanks to you too. So, hi, Jose. How are you? Oops, your microphone is off. Hi, Kevin.
Hi, Miss. How are you?
I'm fine. Thanks for asking. Okay, José, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estamos? Ahí veamos si podemos probar el micrófono. Señores, bueno, no recuerdo. Bueno, yo creo que sí habíamos quedado pendiente con una homework. Y vamos a comparar antes de iniciar con todo lo que vamos a hacer hoy, que yo espero que nos alcance el tiempo. Vamos a iniciar con esta práctica que yo creo que fue una tarea que yo les dejé, no me acuerdo. Pero y si no, pues aquí la vamos a hacer. Fácil, en este caso lo único que vamos a hacer es pasar las oraciones a pasado simple. Tengo el verbo go, see, do, wait, have, be, walk, take, talk, give, come, and eat. Por ejemplo, en este caso, he got swimming yesterday. Si yo la quiero pasar a pasado, obviamente aquí tendría que decir he got, pero como el ejercicio es pasar la oración a pasado simple, en este caso el pasado de go es went. He went swimming yesterday. Letter B. En este caso, they see a film last night. ¿Cómo la paso a pasado simple?
They saw a
They
film last night.
saw a
Ok,
film last night.
thank you, ladies. They saw a film. El pasado de see es saw. They saw, ellos vieron el que una película. They saw a film last night. Letter C, I do my homework. ¿Cómo sería el pasado? Yo hice mi tarea.
Did my homework.
I did, thank you, lady. Ya veo que las señoritas se pusieron las pilas. I did my homework. Yo hice. Letter D, you wait for an hour. Como la pasó pasado, tú esperaste por una hora.
You waited for an hour.
Perfect, excellent. You waited for an hour. Es un verbo regular porque simple y sencillamente le agregó ed y ya la pasó en este caso pasado simple. Letter E, Michael have a cold. ¿Cómo digo Michael tuvo un resfriado?
Michael had a cool.
Michael had a cold. ¿Cuál es el pasado de have? Had. Michael had a cold. Oh, Michael had a cold. Letter F. The teacher be late. ¿Cómo digo la teacher o el maestro estuvo tarde? Como dando a entender que llegó tarde. The teacher
The teacher was late.
was, porque es tercera persona, utilizamos was. Muy bien. Bueno, y los caballeros, a saber qué les pasó hoy. The teacher was late. Vamos con letra G. Sue and Juan walked to school today. ¿Cómo la pasó a pasado? Caminaron a la escuela hoy.
Sue and Juan
Juan walked.
walked to school today.
Ok,
Today.
walk. No te preocupes, Robert, ya le voy a dar un pequeño brief ahí. Sue and Juan walk to school today. Vamos con la siguiente. El verbo es take. ¿Cuál sería el pasado? Por ejemplo, yo llevé a mi perro a caminar.
I took
I
my dog
took
for a walk.
my dog for a walk.
I took my dog for a walk. El pasado de take es took, un verbo irregular porque cambia su forma. I took my dog for a walk. Letter I. She talked to her friends. Como digo, ella habló con sus amigos.
She talked to her
She
friends.
talked, ok. She talked to her friends. Por eso fue que la semana pasada estuvimos viendo bastantes verbos de presente a pasado simple, porque obviamente para que no les costara hacer este tipo de ejercicios. Igual acuérdense que para eso quedan las clases grabadas también, por si usted tiene alguna duda, consulta, vea. O teacher, mire, no me quedó claro eso también. Entonces, she talked to her friends. Ella habló Vamos con el siguiente, el verbo es give. Pasado de give, we
gave. We gave.
We gave him que conmueve. Muy bien. We gave him. Nosotros le dimos a él las respuestas. We gave him the answers. Letter K, Marcela, pasado de come. Marcela vino a la fiesta.
Marcela came to the party.
Marcela came to the party. Y la última, the dog, pasado de eat.
At.
Eight. My dog ate my breakfast. Ok, quiero que observe acá para hacer un pequeño repaso. El ejercicio es pasar todas las oraciones a pasado. Los verbos, como se los mencioné antes, era go, see, do, etcétera, etcétera. Tengo el verbo go. Si yo quiero decir en este caso él fue, el pasado de go es went, he went. El pasado de see es saw. Por ejemplo, they saw a film. El pasado de do es did. Por ejemplo, I do my homework, yo hago mi tarea. El pasado, I did, yo hice mi tarea. Tengo un verbo regular que es wait, que significa esperar. Si yo quiero pasarlo a pasado, waited. Es un verbo regular porque se le agrega ed. Tengo el verbo have. El pasado de have es had. Michael tuvo un resfriado. Michael had a cold. Tengo en este caso el pasado, el verbo to be. Recuerde que para el verbo to be pueden ser was o puede ser were. En este caso utilizamos was porque es tercera persona. La teacher estuvo tarde, como van a entender que llegó tarde. The teacher was late. Tengo el verbo walk, usted sabe que es caminar, pero si yo quiero decir que ellos caminaron, Sue and Juan walk. Tengo el verbo take, que es agarrar. Muchas veces los alumnos dicen, tomar. Lo que pasa es que si usted dice tomar, se entiende como que es una bebida. Pero en este caso es como agarrar. Entonces, I took my dog for a walk. En este caso, I took. O sea, yo agarré a mi perro para ir a caminar. O sea, yo llevé a mi perro a caminar. I took my dog for a walk. Tengo el verbo talk, que es hablar. El pasado de talk es talk. No talk it. Es talk. Tengo give, pasado, gave. Tengo come, el pasado, came. Y eat, el pasado, ate. Solo era pasar, en este caso, las oraciones a pasado simple. Ok. Si usted ve un poco pequeña la letra, usted puede darle zoom a su pantalla, en este caso, para que usted pueda ver la letra más gigante. Tengo una conversación en pasado simple, antes de pasar, obviamente, a la pregunta que les mandé en la mañana, cómo estuvo tu fin de semana. Tengo esta conversación y obviamente la conversación está en pasado simple. Preparémonos porque voy con parejas. Dice, hi Jessica, how are you? ¿Se recuerdan que yo estaba hablando, entonces fue el día viernes o el día jueves? Cuando yo tengo una pregunta, le doy la entonación, porque una cosa es pronunciación y otra cosa es entonación. Hi, Jessica, how are you? So far, so good. Yo siempre que les pregunto a ustedes, hey, how are you? ¿Cuál es la respuesta más común que dan los alumnos?
I'm fine.
And you, dicen todos. Entonces, no es que esté malo. No, claro que está bien. Lo que pasa es que como para practicar un poquito de vocabulario. How are you? So far, so good. ¿Qué significa esta expresión? So far, so good.
Por el momento, todo está bien.
Ok, por el momento, todo está bien. No me puedo quejar, ¿verdad? En este caso, so far, so good. What about you? Esta, what about you? Es como decir, ¿y a ti cómo te va? What about you? Y le responde, I am all right. I am all right. So, how was? ¿Cómo estuvo? How was your weekend? I was busy, no busy, busy. Yo estuve ocupado. Yo estuve ocupada. I was busy. And it was tiring. Y estuvo cansado. O sea, como un fin de semana cansado. Tiring. Viene del adjetivo tired. Tiring. Why? I was busy doing some course. ¿Qué es course? esta no es chores, no es cho, es con C. Course. La H desaparece. Obviamente estoy haciendo eso porque ya vamos a practicar en parejas. I was busy doing some chores. Chores son como los quehaceres de la casa. Chores. I was doing some chores. Like, esta palabra, like. Teacher, el like es cuando yo digo, por ejemplo, I like pizza. A mí me gusta la pizza. Sí, pero en este caso el like se ocupa también cuando yo voy a dar, ok, por ejemplo, I was busy doing some chores. Por ejemplo, like, no solo se puede utilizar como, I like pupusas, I like pizza, I like chocolate, I like bla, bla, bla. El like se puede utilizar como en este caso decir, por ejemplo, I was busy doing some chores, like, o sea, como por ejemplo, washing dishes, vacuuming, no es vacuum no, es vacuuming, doing laundry, no es laundry, es con O, doing laundry. I also babysat my friend's children yesterday. Me encanta esta expresión. ¿Qué es babysat? ¿Qué les da a entender cuando dice, and I also babysat my friend's children yesterday? Any idea?
Es como una niñera.
Exacto. Como, también cuidé de los niños de mis amigos ayer. Exacto, como una niñera. Puede ser babysat. Y hay otra palabra que es baby.
City.
Babysit. Babysit. Exacto. Muy bien. So I also babysat my friend's children yesterday. Ok. You must be tired. Hey, tú debes de estar cansado. You must be tired. How often do you babysit? Miren cómo cambia, sat o sit, ambas están correctas. How often do you babysit the children? Sometimes, not often. Sometimes, a veces, not often. ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre sometimes y not often? Sometimes.
Algunas veces.
¿Y not often?
Con frecuencia.
No siempre.
No siempre, exacto, siempre. No siempre. Con frecuencia sería frequently, frequently. Okay, aquí, okay. No often, no siempre, muy bien. My friends, no es es con E. My friends could not, aquí podemos decir couldn't también, podemos contractarlo. My friends couldn't find the sitter. O sea, mis amigos no pudieron encontrar. ¿El qué no pudieron encontrar? Encontrar, perdón. Encontrar, les dije. ¿El qué no pudieron encontrar? My friends couldn't find. Ajá,
una niñera.
Excelente, caballero. Una niñera. So, I babysat for them. How about you? Hey, esta otra forma de, por ejemplo, how are you? So far, so good. How are you? Esa otra forma también de preguntar, en vez de decir and you, aunque es más fácil, teacher, decir and you. Sí, pero como aquí vamos a practicar vocabulario. How about you? How about you? Or how about you? Do you have a good weekend? Yes, I had a great weekend. What do you do? I had dinner with my friends on Saturday. And we played a board game together. Hey, ¿qué es board game? ¿Un juego de?
Es como un juego de tablas, le iba a decir yo.
Ajá, o sea, un juego de. Como un
board game.
Exacto.
Sí, se me viene a la mente como, como surf, quizás, algo así.
No, aquí en este caso como juegos de mesa. Board. Yes. Table game, dicen algunos lugares, también es válido. Le dice a Jessica, that sounds fun. How was the food? Hey, ¿cómo estuvo la comida? How was the food? Y le responde, it was good. We had some pasta, chicken, and steamed vegetables. Hey, ¿qué es steamed? vegetable. ¿Qué forma? O sea, vegetable ya sabe que es vegetales, pero cuando dice steamed vegetables, ¿qué tipo de vegetales?
Cocidos.
Ese es, ok, no. Ese sería boil.
Salteado.
Salteado. Las mujeres como que manejamos un poquito más ese vocabulario, ¿verdad? Pero cocidos y salteados, sí, en este caso, como, digamos que sí, ¿verdad? Cocidos sí, pero lo más correcto es salteados. That sounds, no es sound, es con A. Sounds delicious. Yeah, it was. I didn't know that my friend was such a good cook. A good cook. Hay muchas formas de decir cocinero. ¿Cuáles son? ¿Me quedé sin alumnos? Ajá. ¿Cuáles son las formas de decir cocineros o cocinero?
Chef.
Chef, cookers. ¿Es una?
Cookers.
Cookers, si no otra.
Cook.
And cook, exacto, muy bien. Si conocen otra, ahí me avisan. How about you? Are you a good cook? ¿Qué le pregunta? ¿Eres tú qué?
Cocinero, un buen cocinero.
¿Eres un buen cocinero? I don't know. O no, I don't know. I don't know o I don't know. But I try to cook for my family sometimes. Ay, pero yo trato. I try, yo trato. I try to cook. Yo trato de cocinar. Pues, obviamente puedo decir, hey, yo trato de aprender inglés todos los días. ¿Cómo sería eso? Yo trato de aprender inglés todos los días.
I try to learn English every day.
I try to learn English every day. Excelente. I like cooking too. Ah, a mí también me gusta cocinar. I like cooking too. But I don't like to go grocery shopping. ¿Qué no me gusta?
Las compras groseras.
No.
¿Ir al supermercado?
Uy, perdón, permítame que ya iba a dejar aquí de compartir. I don't like to go grocery. Ir al supermercado. O sea, no me gusta hacer las compras, pues vaya. Y le dice, ah, en este caso, oh, I see. Ah, ya veo. Oh, I see. Well, I got to go now. Me tengo que ir. Hay gente que dice, I gotta go. También se puede. I gotta go now. But it was a nice talking to you. Yes, me too. I will see you tomorrow. Yeah, see you soon. Bye, bye. Ok, señores, ¿quién quiere practicar inglés?
Me, teacher.
Karen, number one. I need a volunteer. Second, please. Thank you, Fabi. Ok, nice. Se prepara para la segunda, se prepara René y Roberto. Ok, Karen, you are going to be Jim. And okay. Fabi, you are going to be Jessica. Go ahead.
Hi, Jessica. How are you?
So far, so good. What about you?
I'm all right. So, how was your weekend?
I was busy and I was tidying.
Why?
I was busy doing some chores like washing dishes.
Busy. Okay.
I was busy doing some chores like washing dishes, vacuuming, doing laundry. Also, babysat my friend's children yesterday.
You must be tired. How often do you babysit the children?
Sometimes. Not often. My friends couldn't find the sitter, so I babysat for them. What about you? Do you have a good weekend?
Yes, I had a great weekend.
What do you do?
I had dinner with my friends on Saturdays and we play a board game together.
That sounds fun. How was the food?
It was good. We had some pasta, chicken, and steam vegetable.
This sounds delicious.
Yeah, it was. I didn't know that my friend was such a good cook.
How about you? Are you a good cook?
Perdón.
I don't know.
Karencita, such. No such, es con A, es con O, such.
Such. Okay, again, yeah, please. It was I didn't know that my friend was such...
Such a good cook.
Such a good cook.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Okay. Such a cook. How about you? Are you a good cook?
I don't know, but I try to cook for my family sometimes.
I like cooking too, but I don't like to grocery shopping.
Oh, I see.
Well, I got to go now, but it was nice talking to you.
Yes, me too. I will see you tomorrow.
Yeah, see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Excellent. Thank you, ladies. Tomamos un pequeño descanso. Hello, René. Are you ready? Excellent.
Sí.
Robert, are you ready too?
Pero tengo una duda.
Yes, teacher.
Ok, dime, René, porfa.
¿Qué era grocery? Ya no me acuerdo.
Grocery, ¿a dónde está la palabra? Es cuando vas a hacer los comprados, por ejemplo, grocery. Incluye todo. Verdura, fruta, lácteos, carnes, cosas para el hogar. Groceries. Incluye todo, 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 todo.
Ajá, ok.
Ok, so let's see. Well, Robert, you are going to be Jean. And René, you are going to be Jessica. Ok, caballeros, se prepara Kevin and Aníbal. Go ahead, please.
Hi, Jessica, how are you?
Bueno, si quieren, cambien el nombre. O sea, así como que, hi, René, hi, Robert.
Hi, René, how are you?
So far, so good. What about you?
I am all right. So how was your weekend?
I was busy. It was tiring.
Busy.
I was busy and it was tiring.
Why?
I was busy doing some course.
Excellent.
I was busy doing some chores like washing dishes, vacuuming, doing laundry. I also babysat my friend's children yesterday.
You must be tired. How often do you babysit the children?
Sometimes, not often. My friends call not find the sitter. So I babysat for them. Who about you? Did you have a good weekend?
Yes, I had a great weekend.
What did you do?
I had dinner with my friends on Saturday and we played a board game together.
That sounds fun. Who was the food?
It was good. We had some pasta, chicken, and steaming vegetables.
That sounds delicious.
Yeah, it was. I didn't know that my friend was such a good cook.
What about you? Are you a good cook?
I don't know, but I try to cook for my family sometimes.
I like cooking too, but I don't like to go grocery shopping.
Oh, I see.
Well, I got to go now, but it was nice talking to you.
Yes, me too. I will see you tomorrow.
Yeah, see you soon.
Bye, René.
Excellent.
Bye, Robert.
Thank you, gentlemen. Okay, let's continue. Hi, Kevin. Are you ready?
I'm ready, teacher.
Perfect. Hi. Let's see. I said Aníbal, right? Perfect.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so Aníbal, you are going... Solamente para que se identifiquen, pero en este caso pueden... O sea, con sus nombres. So, Aníbal, you are going to be Jim. And Kevin, you are going to be Jessica. Okay, gentlemen, caballeros, go ahead, please.
Hi, Kevin. How are you?
So far, so good. What about you?
I'm all right. So, how was your weekend?
I was busy and was tired.
Why?
I was busy doing some chores like washing dishes, vacuuming, doing laundry. I also babysat my friend's children yesterday.
You must be tired.
You must. You must.
You must. By tired. How often do you babysit the children?
Sometimes. Now often my friends call not find the sitter, so I babysat for them. How about you? How about you? Did you have a good weekend?
Yes, I had a great weekend.
What did you do?
I had dinner with my friend on Saturday, and we played a board game together.
That sounds fun. How was the fun?
It was good. We had some pasta, chicken, and steamed vegetables.
That sounds delicious.
Yeah, it was. I didn't know that my friend and was super good cook.
How about you? Are you a good cook?
I don't know, but I try to cook for my family sometimes.
I like cooking too, but I don't like to grocery shopping.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I see.
Well, I go now, but it was nice talking to you.
It was nice talking to you.
It was nice talking to you.
Excellent.
Yes, me too. I will see you tomorrow.
Yeah, see you soon.
Bye. Bye. Thank Bye. You so much, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, I'm going to finish with Karen Rugamas. Ready?
Yes.
Excellent. And Jose, are you ready too?
Yes.
Perfect. Okay, Karen, you are going to be Jessica, and Jose, you are going to be Jim. Okay, please go ahead.
Hi, Jessica. How are you?
So far, so good. What about you?
I am all right. So, how was your weekend?
I was busy and in the was tiring.
Why?
I was busy doing some chores like washing dishes, vacuuming, doing laundry. I also babysat my friend's children yesterday.
You must be tired. How often do you babysit the children?
Sometimes, not often. My friends call Nofin the steerer, so I babysat for them. How are you? How about you? Did you have a good weekend?
Yes, I had a great weekend.
What did you do?
I had dinner with my friends on Saturday, and we played board games together.
That sounds fun. How was the food?
it was good. We had some pasta, chicken, and steamed
vegetables. Vegetables?
Vegetables?
Yes.
That sounds delicious.
Yeah, it was. I didn't know that my friend was such a good cook.
Such a good cook.
How about you? Are you good a cook?
Are you a good cook?
I don't know, but try to cook for my family sometimes.
I like cooking too, but I don't like to go grocery shopping.
Oh, I see.
Well, I got to know, but it was nice talking to you.
Yes, me too. I will see you tomorrow.
Yeah, see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, excellent. Thank you so much. Okay, my dearest students, let's continue with this one. This is very easy. How was your weekend? ¿Cómo estuvo tu fin de semana? So far, so good. En este caso, recuerden que ustedes pueden inventar, o sea, ¿qué fue lo que hicieron en este caso para practicar vocabulario? So, my example is this one. So far, so good. On Saturday, I went to the beach. I went to the beach with some friends. We have an incredible barbecue for lunch. And then we decide to make a bonfire on the beach. Sunday was not exception. We had a great breakfast time. I made some scrambled eggs, toast, and jam. In the evening, we went to swimming in the pool, and then I came back to home at 9 p.m. Was an awesome weekend. So, is there any volunteer who wants to participate first? Please let me know, any volunteer?
Me, teacher.
Excellent, thank you, Robert. Okay,
solo
Robert.
Una consulta, teacher.
Dime, hijo.
Este, para decir, comimos o tomamos.
Okay, pero comimos, por ejemplo, en el almuerzo, o comimos algo específico, porque hay dos formas de decirlo.
Ah, por ejemplo,
we ate.
Tomamos.
O I
we
ate.
Ate.
Yo comí o nosotros comimos. I ate o we ate. Pues comimos pizza.
Ah, ok.
We ate pizza. Pero si en ese caso yo quiero decir, y nosotros desayunamos, ahí sería we had breakfast. Ahí se los mando. Desayunamos. We had breakfast. Ok. Are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Ok, Fabi. You are going to be the second one, right?
Yes, teacher.
Perfect. Okay, so Robert, how was your weekend?
So far, so good. On Saturday, I went to the cinema with my sister and my mother. We had an amazing salida, teacher, ¿cómo se dice?
We have an incredible, podemos ponerte así, mira, trip, ahí te lo mando al chat. We had an amazing trip.
We had an amazing trip and ate a lot of popcorn, pizza.
Mm-hmm.
We had drunk.
Mm-hmm. Perdón, so, espérame, que pensé que te los había mandado ahí. Okay, ahí está, trip, excuse me. Okay.
Pensé que lo habíamos al grupo. Okay, continue. Excuse me. Okay. Sunday was not the exception. We had a great breakfast time. I made some sandwich and drank a cup of coffee. Sunday sleep a lot and watch a series on Netflix. Finish, teacher.
Okay, excelente. Detallito, por ejemplo, si me voy a esto en general. Thank you, Robert. Nice. Detallito chiquito, si yo me voy a referir a un día, por ejemplo, el sábado, On Saturday. Ah, el domingo. On Sunday. Detallito chiquitito. Thank you, Robert. Let's see, Fabi, are you ready?
Yes.
Can you please, before to continue, help me to choose the next big thing. Aníbal, Karen Méndez, Karen Rugamas, Kevin, René.
Karen Rugamas.
Okay, Karen Rugamas, nos preparamos. Fabi, how was your weekend?
Okay, so far, so good, because I was out all weekend.
Mm-hmm.
On Saturday, I went to the shopping at supermarket, and I went to take a breakfast in a new restaurant for my family and me. Also, I went to barbershop.
But you? Or...
Because no, for my nephew and my
dad. Okay, got it. Yes. Uh-huh.
Barber shop.
Ya te iba a decir beauty salon para las mujeres.
Beauty supply. No. I went to barber shop because they cut my nephew and my dad hair. Mm-hmm. On Sunday, I went to shorts and I took the breakfast in the mall, La Gran Vía. I had good time with my family. Well, I say my family, but only I am with my older sister, my nephew, and my mm-hmm. father, because my mother and my brother-in-law are in travel for United States. And finally, for the dinner on Sundays, we cook the barbecue
mm-hmm.
for was a time to relax. Only that.
Okay, detallito, ahí te los mando a todos. Ok, uh-huh. La forma en cómo dices de cortarte el cabello, tu papá y tus sobrinos también, pero por ejemplo, en este caso, si yo quiero decir, mi papá se cortó el cabello, por decirlo así, my dad got a haircut. Mi papá y mi sobrino se cortaron el cabello. My dad and nephew got a haircut. Y no es cook it, es cook. Excelente. Thank you, Fabi. Ok. Karen Rugamas, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Perfect. Please choose one. Aníbal, Karen Méndez, Kevin o René. José, todavía no te elijo hasta que me digas que te sientes preparado, hijo. Ok, choose one, Karen, please.
Kevin.
Except José. Ok, Kevin, nos preparamos. Karen, how was your weekend?
My weekend was normal. On Saturday, I worked until the afternoon, and then I went to the supermarket, and on Sunday, I got up late. We went to have lunch, and then we sleep in the afternoon, only that.
Okay, muy bien. Zero mistakes. Muy bien. Excelente. Thank you, Karen. Let's see, Kevin, ready?
No.
invent.
Pero me ayuda.
Sí, hombre, okay, don't worry. Wait. Choose one. Aníbal, okay. Karen Méndez o René.
Karen.
Okay, Karencita, nos preparamos. Kevin, ¿cómo estuvo tu fin de semana? How was your weekend?
So far so good.
Mm-hmm.
This weekend in specific, aburrido, ¿cómo sería?
Boring, teacher? Se los mando al chat. Boring.
This weekend in specific, boring.
Was boring. Fue aburrido, was boring.
Yeah, Saturday, all day.
I stay at home.
Perdón.
Me quedé en casa, por ejemplo. I stayed at home.
No, my Saturday all day in my work.
Okay.
Seven o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Saturday, and stay at my home. Dijo, ¿verdad?
At home. Mm-hmm.
At home, stay my home.
Y ahí le podemos agregar todo el día. I stay at home all day.
I stay at home all day. Watching series in Netflix.
Mm-hmm.
I do the laundry.
I did, pasado, yo hice. Yo lavé la ropa.
Okay. I did the laundry and nothing more.
Okay.
It's boring. This weekend, yeah, it's boring.
Okay, excellent. Por ejemplo, fue un fin de semana aburrido. Fue, was a boring weekend. O this weekend was boring. Ambas opciones son correctas. Thank you, Kevin. Let's see, Karencita, ready?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, and then I'm going to finish with... No, yes, I got two. Aníbal or René, please?
Aníbal.
Okay, Aníbal, be ready. Okay, Karen, how was your weekend?
My weekend was a great, or sería, I had a great weekend, sería.
Podemos decir, I had a great weekend, o podemos decir, my weekend was great.
Okay. On Sunday morning, I had breakfast with my parents. I cooked for them. Then I course like washing dishes, doing laundry. For lunch, we had an incredible barbecue.
Barbecue.
In the afternoon, we went to the park. Parque Bicentenario.
Bicentenario Park.
And we walked around 2 hours. For dinner, we went to the restaurant and had a good time. We come home around 10 p.m. On Sunday morning, we went to the church. Mm-hmm. And the afternoon, we visited my aunt in Planet de Renderos. And for dinner, we ate pupusas.
Mm-hmm.
And we arrived at home around 8 p.m. and watched some movie with my family. We went to bed around 10 p.m. only.
Excelente. Detallitos. No se dice cook it, se dice cook. Cook. Y por ejemplo, usted dijo I course. En este caso, si yo quiero decir, yo hice los quehaceres de la casa, okay. I did some course. Yo hice los quehaceres de la casa. I did some course. Okay. Course es quehaceres de la casa, ¿verdad? Pero ya para ellos sea, yo hice los quehaceres de la casa, I did. Yo hice, ¿el qué? Some course. Los quehaceres de la casa. Y we come, en este caso, si yo quiero decir, y regresamos, we came, el pasado simple, we came. Alrededor de las 7 de la noche, we came around 7 p.m. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you. Little details. Okay. Let's see. Karencita, you said René or Aníbal? I forgot it.
Aníbal.
Okay. Aníbal, ready?
Yes.
Excellent. And I'm going to finish with you, René. Okay, Aníbal, how was your weekend?
My weekend was very relaxed. I went to the Christmas dinner of one of the company's department. The dinner was Saturday night on the beach, and we chatted with friends from work. And Sunday, I sleep until noon. Finish.
Okay, excellent. Thank you, Aníbal. Zero mistakes. Let's going to finish with you, René. Ready? Always, teacher.
Always.
Okay, René, please. Go ahead. How was your weekend?
My weekend so far so good.
Mm-hmm.
Saturday I went to Café Talon Park with my dog and my parents, and then we had coffee. And then I relaxed in the house. On Sunday morning, I went to church with my parents too. And in the afternoon, I watched TV with my mother. Only that.
Okay, perfect. Excellent. Thank you so much. Okay, señores, para finalizar. El día de mañana no voy a proyectar absolutamente nada de clases porque voy a hacer un ejercicio que a mí realmente me gusta y es la práctica de la conversación. La clase de mañana va a consistir simple y sencillamente que usted va a estar en su lugar favorito de su casa cómodamente porque voy a hacer práctica de conversación. Voy a comenzar con un nivel básico, preguntas como what's your favorite, etcétera, etcétera, what do you prefer, etcétera, etcétera. Y de ahí, dependiendo de cómo yo sienta que usted se va soltando en la conversación, yo le voy a ir agregando un poquito más de nivel. Si yo veo que a usted todavía le cuesta un poquito, que todavía, mire, teacher, a mí todavía no me pregunte, no se preocupe, yo me voy a adecuar a usted. Entonces, teacher, ¿y de qué nos va a preguntar? Es que no es que yo le voy a preguntar algo específico. En este caso va a ser una conversación. Yo voy a comenzar con la típica. What's your name? How old are you? What's your favorite? Y ahí voy a ir. Ok, ya veo que maneja lo básico. Vamos a lo siguiente. Why? ¿Por qué? Preguntas, ok, why do you consider it's necessary to learn a language? Entonces, yo veo que usted me tartamudea así como que me voy a regresar entonces un poquito. Entonces, dependiendo de cómo yo siente el nivel que usted tiene, ahí yo me voy a adecuar a usted, así que no se preocupe. Dicha, pues mañana no me voy a conectar porque yo apenas sé decir my favorite color is blue. No se preocupe que yo me voy a adaptar. Lo que yo quiero es que vayamos ya como que haciendo esas conversaciones ya más fluida. Entonces, simple y sencillamente usted siéntase tranquilo, siéntase tranquila que yo me voy a adaptar a los niveles de ustedes. Así es que, señores, nos vemos el día de mañana a las 9 en punto. Y en este caso, con la primera persona que ingrese, con esa primera persona yo inicio. Así es que, señores, nos vemos mañana y, bueno, vamos a descansar. Pasen una excelente noche y see you tomorrow at 9 p.m. Good night, people.
Good night, teacher.
Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Bye.